Today, I'm in conversation with Dr. Nomita Chandiyog on the sidelines of the 11th National Conference of AIDS Society of India, or ASICON 2018. Dr. Chandiyog has worked as a senior scientist at the Indian Council of Medical Research, or ICMR, as it is more commonly known as, for many years, and she is currently a consultant with ICMR. She has been actively involved with research around biomedical prevention technologies for HIV and other sexually transmitted infections. She is also credited with organizing the only international conference on microbicides held in India. Dr. Chandiyog, can you tell us something about the new biomedical technologies for HIV prevention?
Thank you, Shobha. And I'd first like to thank you for inviting me for this conversation. The new biomedical technologies for HIV prevention, how research has been going on them for so many years. And for many, many years where we thought that they would be a microbicide for women, which women they could use while they were, which would protect them during a sexual act, especially where they would not be able to negotiate a condom. Unfortunately, we did not get favorable results in many of the research studies which were carried out. But recently, in fact, I would say about 7-8 years back, where in 2010 the results came on for oral PrEP. And oral PrEP, which is pre-exposure prophylaxis, where you could take a pill, an antiretroviral tablet every day, which could protect you from getting HIV from your partner, that showed very good results. And currently, oral PrEP is being widely used in many countries around the world. In fact, it's available in 68 countries, and there is a lot of data now on its efficacy, where it's shown to be very effective, and also on its safety. But it also needs behavioral change, because it's important for to be eaten taken every day, because the protection only occurs, if you have taken the tablet and the blood levels of the drug are maintained. It's very similar to taking an oral contraceptive. It's like, if you take a pill a day, you can prevent an unintended pregnancy. And similarly, if you take a pill of oral PrEP a day, you can prevent yourself from getting HIV. But it is recommended that it is given as a package of interventions, as a combination prevention package, in which also there is behavioral interventions for risk reduction. There is also condom promotion. So all of that is, so it is an additional tool for prevention of HIV. So currently, this is really where most of the work is going on, and trying to see how whether it is men or women eating it, how they are adherent to the regimen, because that is the most important thing.
Can you tell us something more about it? Like, can a person be on and off a PrEP, and once the person takes it, what is the time period when it will start working, and or is it to be lifelong for obviously the HIV negative?
So, importantly, it has to be taken by those who are HIV negative. And that is an important thing, because you do not want anybody who is HIV positive to take this drug, because there may be chances of developing resistance to the drug. So periodically, in fact, every 3 months, whoever takes it would need HIV test. And only if you are negative, could you take that drug. The drug can also be taken as an on-off, in the sense that when you feel that you have, there are periods of higher risk, for attainment of HIV, it could be taken then. But then there could be periods where, there is a change of partner, or the partner is not there, or, for any other reason where you feel that now the risk is, you're at a lower risk. At those periods, you know, you could get off the drug, but you wouldn't. But before you, there is a period where you feel that, you know, my risk perception is going to be high. You have to start taking the pill well in advance so that the blood levels are maintained.
And do women in India need more tools in their hands to take care of their sexual and reproductive health, and also to protect them from HIV infection?
Yeah, so certainly, the ultimate would be if we have what we call as multipurpose prevention technologies, which not only protect women from the risk of unintended pregnancy, but also gives them disease prevention. So whether it is STIs, RTIs, or HIV. So there is a lot of research going on to develop these kind of tools where a woman could also not prevent herself from getting unintended pregnancy and also be protected against these. So the thought behind this is that adherence to the implementation tool would be higher because women do have I would not say the threat, but the fear of getting pregnant, of having an unintended pregnancy. And so anything which would prevent her from getting both these, the usage would be much higher.
And also it should be female initiated technology so that she has that negotiating power.
Absolutely right, because you know we really need to empower the women to be able to for their own health needs, you know, rather than be dependent on whether a partner is going to be using something. So this is really very important.
So in your experience as a scientist and moreover a woman scientist, what would you say, what would be your message for the way forward, especially in relation to women?
So I would really say that, so important for women to look after their health. A healthy mother is really looking after a healthy family, and so that really has to be in them that, you know, they start thinking about their own health and how they can move forward in it. And, research is going on all over the world globally to be able to help women. I think that is really going to be the way forward.
Thank you very much, Dr. Chandiyog. We were in conversation with Dr. Namita Chandiyog, who is currently a consultant with Indian Council of Medical Research. Thank you.